400 million. Francois is out. Are you sure, Francois? At 400 million then. Thank you all for your bidding here. And on the telephone to my left. And of course here, Marie and Francois, it is with Alex Rotter at 400 million. Leonardo Salvator Mundi selling here at Christie's. $400 million is the bid. And the piece is sold.
That's sweet, Lord.
I am effective here because I select a clear method for all suckers. I'm all they fall and crawl.
How many of you think this painting is a fake? Yeah, leave me a message below if you do. I don't know, there's just so much going on with that painting. It's like the reluctant release of the condition report, you know, the noticeable differences from what Da Vinci would usually paint with versus what it actually was, the crystal ball, the mistake in the thumb, the provenance. I mean, there are so many questions about it.
Great to be here. So what do you think?
I think it's a real flim-flam. I think that if you really look at this painting, Leonardo never painted anyone remotely like this, never anybody looking dead on, never a surface this dull, inert, a mess. And Christie's claims there's a consensus claiming that it might be real. Actually, it's 12 people. And the foremost Da Vinci expert in the world thinks, on the contrary, that this is not remotely like a Da Vinci.
I'm completely convinced it's by Leonardo.
The reflection of the light in that orb is not right. So there are questions there. Look, Christie's are saying absolutely. The consensus is that this is Da Vinci.
As Todd Levin says, this was a thumping, epic triumph of branding and desire over connoisseurship and reality. Which is absolutely true. I mean, it was a shit show, you know? I still don't know what to think. These are the words that I'm out of. Welcome. It's another day in the studio. Super stoked. Paints are obviously really expensive, so I always take my old palette and I cover it with saran wrap. It's super, super cheap to preserve the paints overnight. And then I'll scoop the paints off this canvas and put it on the new one. Like any that are still fresh and that can be used. Always gotta save that extra money. So yeah, I basically work with these disposable palettes here. I know it may not be the best for the environment, I completely understand that, but I also understand the interest of time, and this has worked for me pretty well, so I just take a little bit of blue tape and I reuse this to tape down the next palette. My dad cut this board for me. And I set this on my lap when I paint. So then I just fold it up like this. And throw this up. And then I'll take the new palette with, of course, the oil paints that I've collected from the last palette. And tape it right down. So yeah, I'm just getting my palette ready for the day. I'm going to continue with the background on War-Torn Mannequin today. Today I'm going to plug in 4 hours, maybe more, and I've got to go to the post office because I'm mailing out all the postcards. Woo! So, got my French press rocking, as always. Going to set that down here. Yeah, got the space heater going. Life's good, man. Can't complain, you know? Last night I went to my first class at the Art Students League. It was really, really cool. I had never been there before. And Robert, my friend, he's the program director there, and he gave me a tour. It's incredible. This school has been running since the mid-1800s, and what they do is they offer really inexpensive classes, really accessible classes for artists. And they have like a full-blown welding studio in the basement, a full-blown ceramic studio, painting studios, an art store. It's really, really a unique and amazing storied and history place. You know, Georgia O'Keeffe, oh God, I couldn't even list all the people that went there, but yeah, so we watched these classical dancers and drew them while watching them. It was really cool. So I hope to go back for another class, you know. It was a good night though. And then I hung out with my friend Vahid and Josie, and then it took me 2 hours to get home. I was like, oh, hell no.
Oh, well, thank you, Robert.
It's like, no, they won't. No, they really won't.
Tools that I have is this. It's called an Otlight, and it's the most natural lighting that you can buy in the market, in my opinion. And it can be pitch black outside, and that light is amazing. Hey, dude.
Hey, can I sit near to eat?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, the sun is not hot enough.
I'm shooting tips and tricks on my YouTube channel.
Okay, cool. I'm gonna be quick anyway because I'm going to yoga.
Yay!
This is my box of backup paint. I've got more unusual colors in here, like Dianthus Pink. That was a gift from a friend. Right now I'm seeking Sevres Blue by Williamsburg. It's a very thick paint. And I'm finding it's very nice. It's also an extremely strong color. Very, very strong. I don't use it very often. I do, however, use Cerulean a lot. All right, so I have an hour and 40 minutes left. Yeah, still rocking it out. It's about 1:52, so working on these background colors. Lots of earth tones. Moving along, though. I only have this last little bit of empty space here. Ooh, okay, just finished painting. Put in about 4.5 hours today. Background's looking killer. All I really have to do last is this guy sitting in the background. And then, of course, the eyes and, you know, the final details, but it's looking good. Let's see if I can get this light pulled out here. Oh, look at that. Sweet. Anyway, so now I'm going to clean up over here and then do some video editing for you. All right, man.
Hope you enjoyed spending the day with me. Let me know your thoughts about the Leonardo below. It's Friday, so you all know that I love Fridays. And Blair's gonna be home soon. I think we're gonna go on a date tonight, so that's awesome. But anyway, have an awesome Friday yourself. Bye.
Wished this Da Vinci into existence. I think it's fake art news.
Make mincemeat of other fools, cause I'm the brother who'll snatch up the funds and make lonely ones. I meant it really, cause I'm clearly obsessed, and these are the words that I manage.